Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Our current session is on theoretical principles behind audiolingual method. I hope and expect by the end of this session, you would have some insight into the theories behind audiolingual method. Well, when it comes to the theory of language learning that operates behind audiolingual method, I would say it derived its theory of language learning from behaviorism. Behaviorism is a school of American psychology which was popular during the 1950s and 1960s. For the behaviorists, human behavior can be reduced to a series of stimuli that trigger a series of corresponding responses. So what the behaviorists believe in is that there is a stimulus and the learner responds to that stimulus. And this response depends upon the nature of the stimulus. The series of, or you know, the chain of such stimulus or such stimuli would result in a chain of responses. Consequently, they looked at all the learning as a simple mechanism of stimulus, response, and reinforcement. So if the reinforcement is positive, it would lead towards learning. This is what they believed. Their theory of language learning can be summed up in a series of assumptions they made. And I would like to share a few of the basic assumptions that they believed in. The first and the foremost is learning to speak a language is the same as learning to ride a bicycle or to drive a car. Now, if you think of driving a car, how do you learn driving a car? Or how do you learn riding a bicycle? Are you successful on day one? Of course, you are not. So it is through practice, it is through drill, it is through the sense of achievement that you have, through that a habit is formed, and thus you learn how to keep control and how to manage all the gadgets and how to ride a bicycle or how to drive a car. The second important assumption was that language learning is just a process of mechanical habit formation through repetition. So drill or repetition is one of the major components of audiolingual method, and this mechanical drill leads to mechanical habit formation. Forming a habit in the context of language learning is described as developing the ability to perform a particular linguistic feature. The third important assumption is habit formation takes place by means of analogy rather than analysis. So it's not about critically thinking about it or critically analyzing it. It's about comparing and contrasting. Analysis involves problem solving, whereas analogy involves the perception of similarities and of dissimilarities or differences of the two. So it focused on analogy. The fourth assumption is language learning is a linear, incremental, additive process. So it is step by step, linear, 1, 2, 3, 4. It goes in a line, it goes one step after the other. It's an incremental process. It takes place gradually from one step to the other, and it is additive. Every new stimulus adds, every new response that is given to that stimulus adds to the learning process, and the overall accumulation of, you know, the learning takes place. Finally, it believed that discrete items of language should be introduced in carefully constructed dialogues embedded in a carefully selected linguistic and cultural context. So one of the major assumptions of audiolingual method is that it believes contextualizing what is being taught, and it gives importance to the cultural context. Language should not be separated from culture. As far as the theory of language teaching is concerned, audiolingual theory of language teaching is in fact a mirror image of its theory of language learning. Why it is so? Because learning a language is considered to involve forming habits in order to assimilate and use a hierarchical or a system or an incremental system, language teaching is nothing more than a planned presentation of those systems or subsystems combined with provision of opportunities for repetition. What does all this mean? Providing incremental small pieces of information, of language to the students or to the learners, giving them drill in that through repetition, thus forming their habit of using them. This is what language teaching and learning according to audiolingual method is. The purpose of teaching according to audiolingual method is twofolded. The first purpose is, in the initial stage, the teacher using a textbook serves as a model, providing samples of linguistic input, and then in the later stage acts as a skillful manipulator of questions, commands, imperatives, and other cues in order to elicit correct responses from the learners. So all the input comes from the teacher at the initial stage, and later on, through the process of drill, a habit formation is done. Linguistic input is presented in the form of dialogues because they involve a natural and exclusive use of the audiolingual skills. All the elements of the sound system appear repeatedly, including the suprasegmental phonemes, which are often the most difficult for the learner. All that is learned is meaningful according to audiolingual method, and what is learned in one part of the dialogue often makes meaning clear in another. What does it mean? It means one structure of language or one item of language that is learned at one stage through the drill or through the repetitive presentation. It may not make much sense and meaning to the learners at that stage, but later on when it is used in some other combination or in some other drill or in some other stimulus response habit formation process, it would make meaning for the learner. Given the preference of analogy over analysis, pattern practice was considered to be the most important aspect of teaching because it capitalizes on the mind's capacity to perceive identity of structure where there is difference in content and its quickness to learn the analogy. So basically what is done, the students or the learners are taught through the similar structures, and by giving them analogies or by enabling them to understand the similarities and differences in the structures that are presented to them. Besides, teaching the basic patterns helps the learner's performance become habitual and automatic. Through the drills, through the stimulus response process, the learners become so much habitual of using those patterns that it becomes almost automatic. The teacher's major task is to drill the basic patterns. And learners are required drill, drill, and more drill, and only enough vocabulary to make such drill possible. So through this repetitive process in audiolingual method, the learners learn the new language.